get into my lesson, I'm going to start off giving out praises to Yahweh, the Hashem, Yahushah, the Hashem, Rakach, Radash. Give honor to the apostles and elders at Great Millstone that rule well. And our Shalom to the Achim that's on the highways of Byways, the brothers that's in the ministry pushing the true doctrine of Yahweh, Hashem, Yahushah. Just the Achim, the brothers, Shaquat, Gabal, from the Great Millstone, Charlotte Camp, coming at you with another lesson. And once again, my message to you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, which are the true Hebrew Israelites, man. The elect, man. The elect is the only, you know, remnant or the number, 144,000 and one-third, that the Lord, Yahweh Shah, who the world called Jesus Christ, is coming back to deliver, man. But the rest of our people who don't want to take heed is going to, you know, fall into the category of the two-thirds, man. You know, ain't going to be destroyed by these missiles, which is going to be shut off by Russia, you know, China, Pakistan, you know, NATO, which is going to be shut off and going to destroy America, man, which is Babylon the Great, man. You know, so, you know, those that, you know, listen to these videos, you know, and think this is a joke, they better, you know, repent and pray that they part of the elect, man, and come into the fold, man. Like the brothers like us, man, that's on the highways and byways, man. You know, we change our life all around, you know, trying to keep the law, statute, commandment to the best of our ability. You know, go out preaching his word, believing in the doctrine of Yahweh Hashem Yahushah. You know, we're trying to turn ourselves around, man, and be faithful to the Lord, man, so we won't get caught up into this judgment that's about to take place here in America, man. Because America is falling, man. And the next thing that after the America's dollar collapse is going to be this RFID chip, you know, which is the mark of the beast. You know, and then also you're going to have World War III, you know, and race war, you know, all type of judgment that the Lord Yahweh Hashem Yahushah is going to have come upon this earth, man, mainly America, man. And you want to be part of the elect, man. That's why your brothers go out there, you know, do the work and just show their faith. And also, you know, so the Lord can have mercy upon us to deliver us, you know, in the times of Jacob trouble and all hell break loose, man. You know, but, you know, basically, man, you know, I'm going to get into, you know, my lesson about, you know, spiritual power, man. You know, because the times that we're coming into, like I, you know, explained it, you know, we praying that the Lord have mercy upon us. And also, you know, that waiting on the Lord, you know, and doing, man, the Lord also going to give us the elect men spiritual power, man, to fight against their enemies, man, which are you so-called white people, man, you Edomites, and the military, and these foreign troops that's going to invade America, man. You know, so, you know, the people out there, you know, that don't believe in the faith, man, but believe in the truth, man, you know, one thing they're going to make them believe or bug out, and the Lord Yahweh Hashem Yahushah give this man spiritual power, man, to do, you know, wonderful acts, man. You know, that's what we're looking for, man, because when you're breaking down the word, you know, Israel, which in the Hebrew is Yah, Shah, Allah, meaning He, Prince of Power, man. And you Negro, Latino, Native Americans are the princes of power, man. So, you know, right now, you know, it might seem like we don't have any, you know, hope or power. But the Lord, Yahweh Hashem Yahushah, will give his men spiritual power for those that believe on him, man. You know, and you're going to have the majority of our people, you know, which came up against the truth, these scoffers and scorners, man. You know, they're going to see the men of the Lord with that power, man, when the Lord restore that power on them, man. You know, they're going to be, you know, wanting to get with the program, man. But for a lot of them, man, it's going to be too late, man. So this is on Psalms 110, verse 2. I start off at verse 2. The Lord, Yahweh, shall send the rod of thy strength out of Zion, rule thou in the midst of thy enemies. So the Lord, that rod means, a rod represents rulership, man. The Lord going to raise up the nation of Israel, man. The Negro, Latinos, and Native Americans, starting off with the elect, those that's in the faith, and doing the work that Yahweh Hashem Yahushah and truth and sincerity, man. Verse 3, the people shall be willing in the day of thy power. So the Lord going to give us that power, man, when our enemies come up against us. It's going to include you two-thirds, man, because you're not with the Lord, man. You don't want to get down with the program of Yahweh Hashem Yahushah, you're coming against him. So the Lord, you know, look at y'all as enemies, man. You know, but ultimately, man, the enemies are talking about, you know, you so-called white people, man. You elites, man. And the rest of you heathen nations that got the military geared up to come against the so-called Negro, Latino, and Native American, man. Mainly your martial law, man. you know, your plan is to destroy the so-called Negro Latino Native Americans, man, the nation of Israel. But the Lord will give his men that power, man, to fight against y'all, man. But the Lord Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, the true power and the only power is with the so-called Negro Latino Native Americans, man. Starting off with the elect, man. So, because we ain't going to need no guns, no tanks, no fighter jets, no super soldier suit, man. No, the Lord going to give us that power to manipulate the elements, man. You know, to shoot energy out our hands, giving us the ability to fly, you know, giving us the ability to, you know, to run at top speed, to jump high, you know, super sprint, you know, on the ability to, you know, control fire, ice, lightning, you know, all the elements, man. So the Lord is with us, man. Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah got all power, man. You know, he's going to give us the ability, you know, to, you know, raise the dead, heal the sick. Just like how the ancient men or the ancient prophets had in the, you know, back in the past times, how he gave Moses power, you know, gave Daniel, you know, Samuel, David, you know, Samson, the 12 disciples, the Maccabees, you know, so we the same people from, you know, of that same bloodline from back then, man. So the Lord definitely going to give us spiritual power, man. And we're going to need it in the times that we in now, man. Our enemy, you so-called white people, man, you elites, man, and the rest of you heathens, man, will want to come against us, man. But the Lord going to have a surprise for y'all, man. Verse 3, thy people shall be willing in the day of thy power, in the beautiness of holiness from the womb of the morning, and thou has to do or thy youth. You know, so the Lord going to restore that power upon us, man. Just how we had the power back then during the ancient times, during the time of King David and his army, man, how they went to go, you know, conquer the rest of these nations, man, through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, Moses, you know. He went up against Pharaoh, him and Aaron. You know, you had Joshua and Caleb, and they went up against the Canaanites, you know, the Africans. Different accounts, man. The Maccabees, when they went up against the Greeks. You know, so the Lord going to, you know, store that power up on us again, man. We believe in that, man. We have faith in that, man, because we're going to need Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, man. And that's going to be one of the ways of our defense, man. Lord raising us up with that spiritual power, man. You know, why you think, you know, Esau, these fake Jews, man, the Amalekites put it in their movies when it comes to Marvel, you know, DC comic books, you know, Dragon Ball Z, you know, because they reading, getting it from the scriptures, man. And they know our history, man. They got the facts, the artifacts, and, you know, how vast of a nation we was when it came to fighting, man. You know, when it came to the man or the Lord being a great military for Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, because the scriptures say that the Lord Yahweh is a man of war, man. So the Lord loved action, man. He loved fighting, man. And what would it be if he don't have his chosen people fighting in the battle, man? You know, so the Lord gonna raise his men up, man, and make them his weapon His weapon and to destroy these people out here, man. Especially you heathens, man. You know, because that's how the Lord, you know, done things, man. Look how Lord Yahweh Shah gave his men, you know, the 12, you know, spiritual power, man, to heal, you know, to cast out demons out of people who were sick. You know, he was giving them power to, you know, to heal the lame, people who couldn't walk. The dumb, people who couldn't speak, you know, healing the people who was blind, you know. It was doing all type of, you know, miracles, man, through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, man. And we had that same power today, man. That's why these devils don't want us to get the name of the Lord, man. That's why they try so much to hide this truth from us, man. Because they know once we get back in connection with Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, the true power, man, how he was going to restore us and raise us up again, man. But it wasn't their will anyway, man, because it was always the will of the Lord that he brought us down, man, for what we done in our past life, and, you know, how we went off in this life, coming up against him and going against his law, statute, commandment. But through the spirit of Paul Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, working with our apostles, elders, and great millstone, and their elders, you know, going back during the time of, you know, the house of David and, you know, one West, you know, storing that there's a spirit and raising us up again, how we are now in the day, man, because we believe that we are the true men of the Lord, man. And he's getting ready to raise us up again, just like how he did in the ancient times, to conquer all these nations again, man. Well, this is Luke chapter 10, verse 18. And he said unto them, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven. And this talking about Satan represent you so-called white people, man. You elites, man. Falling from heaven. Heaven represent, you know, you your rulership, man. The devil time we coming into now, man. You elites, man. You Illuminati. You super rich bankers, man. Y'all thinking that y'all going to implement the RFID chip, the mark of the beast, and rule the world with your new world order and your plan, not knowing that Yahweh Shah got you in the trick bag, man. He about to bring y'all down, man. And the Lord say he saw Satan fall from heaven as lightning, man. And, you know, lightning falls so quick, man, that before you know, see the lightning, it already going back up, man. So that how fast you so-called white people, you Edomite, New World Order, or kingdom, going to fall, man. Quick, man. And right before you know it, Yahweh Shah going to have y'all in slavery, man. And have y'all getting, you know, getting your head bust open by the men of the Lord, man. Well, because that's what's going to happen, man. Because in the kingdom, man, ain't going to be no lovely-dovely all nations coming together, man. Lord going to set up one nation over another, man. He's setting the Negro, Latino, Native American, the Israelites over the rest of you nation, man. And we ain't going to just sit there and look at y'all, man. We're going to put y'all in hardcore slavery, and we're going to whip you, and we're going to do all type of, you know, violence to y'all, man, what y'all done to us, man. Didn't y'all done that to the Negro, Latino, Native American, man? Did you so-called white people slaughter the Native Americans for this land? The Mexican, the Puerto Rican, you know? Then y'all took the Southern Kingdom, which are the Negroes, you know, and the Jamaicans and the Haitians. And what y'all done to them, man? Hunger, you know, wolf them, you know? Put them in hardcore slavery. So the time coming that the Lord's going to repay y'all, you know, back for what y'all done to his people, man. And the Lord said, we're going to do double unto y'all, man. And we're going to have spiritual power to do it, man. Verse 19, behold, I give unto you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy, nothing shall by any means hurt you. So, you know, Lord will give us power, man, over our enemies, man. And he said, nothing is going to hurt us, man. So your guns, your tanks, you know, your different biological warfare, you know, your plagues that you got, store and the CDC to push out on the people to make the people sick, man. Nothing gonna hurt us, man. Lord gonna make us, you know, basically Superman, man, to come against y'all, man. But the Lord Yahweh Shemiah Shah is gonna be with us, man. Verse 20. Notwithstanding in this, rejoice not that the spirits are subject unto you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven. Basically, the Lord said, don't be, you know, telling the men of the Lord, don't be, you know, rejoicing that you got the spiritual power. You know, of course, we're going to be glorifying and happy and praising Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shah. And we had get that power, man. But the main thing, the Lord said, you know, rejoice that your name written in heaven, meaning that you are chosen to be part of the elect, man. Because the elect is going to be the one that's going to get that spiritual power first, man, to conquer the enemies, man. And then we're brothers out there in the truth hoping for, man. Because we hoping for salvation to be part of the elect. But we also praying that the Lord give us that spiritual power also, man, to glorify his name and his son name, man. And that one of the main things that, you know, our Lord Yahweh Shah was doing, man, you know, the Lord, you know, was going around preaching, you know, the gospel of Yahweh, you know, telling the nation of Israel, prepare, you know, for the destruction that's going to take place in the last days. You know, what's going to take place, you know, in 70 AD when the Lord, you know, had the Romans ran the nation of Israel out of the land of Israel, into, you know, different parts of the world, man. right before that, while he was preaching, man, he also was healing and doing miracles, wonderful acts, man. You know, healing the people. You know, casting out demons, love. You know, walking on water, turning the wine, turning the water into wine. You know, feeding the people the great multitude with 5 loaves of bread or 2 pieces of fishes, man. You know, because the Lord had that spiritual power, man, controlling the wind, you know, reappearing and disappearing, man. You know, changing his face, man. The Lord did all type of stuff, man. The scripture say that the Lord did so much, you know, acts, man, that the books couldn't contain, you know, the spiritual power that what he's been doing, man. You know, but all throughout the scriptures, when Yahweh Shah, who the word is called Jesus Christ, was in his ministry, man. He was preaching the word of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah. And when he was preaching the word of Yahweh, you know, and also he was, you know, healing the people, showing his power, man, that the Lord gave him, man. And this is what the Lord, you know, told his men that believe on him, man. This is on John 16, verse 23, you know. In that day ye shall ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I say unto you, whatsoever you shall ask the Father in my name, he will give it unto you. So, you know, we go to Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, ask for, you know, anything, man, that which is righteous, man. And the Lord Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah is going to give it to us, man. Why? Because we are a chosen people, man. And we believe on him, man. You know? That's what the Lord is going to give us, man. The spiritual power, man. Salvation, man. You know, all thing we gotta do is believe and ask him, man. This is on John, verse 14, chapter 14, verse 12. Verily, verily, meaning truly, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. And how you believe on the Lord, man. Believing in his name, that it is Yahweh Shah, man, not Jesus. Believing in his image, you know, that he's a so-called dark-skinned man from the tribe of Judah, not a so-called white man, which that image go back to Jezreel Borgia, you know, believing that he died for the nation of Israel, you know, that he going to raise up the nation of Israel, which are the Negro, Latino, Native American, leaving on with the true saying, and the true saying, and what's written in the Holy Scriptures, man, his message, man, you know, and believing that he going to give us that power, man. The works that I do, he shall do also. And greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. And whatsoever you shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may glorify in the Son. You know, so the Lord, you know, anything we ask the Lord Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, man, he gonna give it to us, man. You know, he gonna give us what we need, man, not what we want, man. You know, because the Lord Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah know what we need, man. And the main thing we need is the power of the Lord Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah to deliver us, man. It can be in the form of the angels, you know, the chariot. And it can be in the form of a spiritual power, man, fighting against our enemies, man. But that was the time we coming into, man, that the Lord going to raise up his men again to fight, man. But that was one thing the nation of Israel was known for, man, a nation of warriors, man. Oh, you look into the UFC, you know, you look into the sports and stuff. Majority of these so-called, you know, the ones that, which is now, would be called mighty men back in the ancient days, gladiators, all of them were so-called Negro, Latinos, and Native Americans, man. Majority of them, man. Even though you got most of them that might look white, but majority of them look like the heathens. Majority of them are Israelites, man, through the spirit of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, man. And once again, the Lord is going to raise us up with that fame, man, to conquer our enemies, man. This is on Zechariah chapter 9, verse 13. When I had bent Judah for me, Judah represents the so-called Negroes, Haitians, and Jamaicans, man, which are Judah, Benjamin, Levi, man, the southern kingdom. When I had bent Judah for me and filled a bowl with Ephraim, and Ephraim represents the so-called Puerto Rican, you know, the northern kingdom, the Puerto Rican, you know, the the Seminole Indians, the Mexicans, and which all of them go back to, you know, to, you know, well-respected tribe, man. Gad, Reuben, you know, Manasseh, which are the Cuban, you know, the Dominicans, which are the Simeonites, you know, the tribe of Simeon. You know, the Lord is raising us up again, man. That's why you see the brothers at the tribes coming together, man, you know. When I have built Judah for me and filled a bowl with Ephraim and raised up thy son, so the Lord, you know, comparing us to a bow and arrow, man. And with a bow and arrow, it's a killing instrument, man. So he's going to, you know, raise the nation of Israel up, man. Starting off with the elect. And raise up thy sons, O Zion, against thy sons, O Greece. And Greece, or who? The so-called white people, man. God of the Grecians, man. You know, Alexander the Greek and the Macedonian, you know, the Roman, you know. The Lord is going to raise us up against you so-called white people, man, with that spiritual power, man, and against your army. And made thee as the sword of a mighty man. You know, so the Lord going to make us like a sword, man. And it's a sword representing the killing instrument of destruction, man. This is Amos chapter 9, Amos chapter 9, verse 11. In that day will I raise up the tabernacle of David that is fallen, and close up the branches thereof, and I'll raise up his ruins, and I will build it as in the days of old. So what the tabernacle of David mean? The house of David, man, was considered the elect of the nation of Israel, man. And what was they known for, man? And back in the old, you know, ancient times when David was ruling, man, they was known as a mighty man, taking down these other nations, man. That was one of the main reasons why these nations today hate the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, because they know what we've done unto them when we've been in rulership back then during the time of King David and in the era, man. How much we conquered them, man, and made war against them and, you know, defeating them, man. So now they're taking out that old hatred on us now. But the Lord Yahweh Shem Yahushua is going to raise us up once again, you know, the house of David, you know, the conquer them once again. Verse 12, that they may possess the remnant of Edom and all the heathen which are called by my name, say Yahweh, that doeth this. And that remnant of Edom represent your elites, man. But after the destruction of America, man, when the Lord Yahushua raised up his people, you know, starting off with the elect, man, the remnant, the rest of you Edomites that's going to be left on the earth that don't get caught up in the destruction of the nuclear fire, y'all going to go into slavery, man. And he said, and all of the heathens represent the rest of you heathens going to go into slavery too, man. You know, the Chinese, the Japanese, the Arabs, the East Indians, you know, the people over there in the Philippines, the Aboriginals, which are the sons of Japheth, man. All you heathens are going into captivity under the nation of Israel, man. You know, one thing, you know, brothers out here now is just waiting, man. The Lord tell us to wait on him, man. And the more and more we wait and endure, man, and pray, you know, that time gonna come when the Lord gonna raise his man up with that power, man. And we praying that Yahweh Shem Yahushua will give us that spiritual power, man. But not only going to be, you know, we're going to be glorifying the Lord, man. It's going to be awesome, man. It's going to be fun, man. It's going to be a good feeling, man, to be a superman, man. To be raised up and be able to, you know, do anything through the spirit of Yahweh Shem Yahushua and righteousness, man. And doing the will of the Lord, man. The supernatural power, man. This is let me find one more scripture, a couple more scriptures. Mm-hmm.
This is Micah chapter 5, verse 7. And remnant of Jacob, the remnant represents the elect of Jacob, man, 144,000 and 1/3, shall be in the midst of many people as a dew from the Lord, as the showers upon the grass that tarrieth not for man, nor waiteth for the sons of man. And the remnant of Jacob shall be among the Gentiles, and the Gentiles, in this scripture, is talking about the heathens, man, the natural Gentiles, you so-called white people. You know, you are Chinese, you Japanese, you African, you Arabs, all y'all considered as the Gentiles, man, because the word Gentile means heathens, man. In the midst of many people, as a lion among the beasts of the forest, and as a young lion, as a flock among the flocks of the sheep, who if he go through, both treadeth down and teareth in pieces, and none can deliver. So, you know, Lord gonna raise up his men, you know, in a fierce, you know, matter with that spiritual power, man. It's gonna be like lions, you know, going against a sheep or a lamb, man. And you look at a lion, man, it's a fierce animal, man. You know, that, you know, the strength, man. They, you know, basically, like they call it the king of the jungle, man. A lion is known for being a predator, man. And a sheep and a lamb is known as being defenseless, man. And, you know, so that how, you know, bad the Lord Yahweh Shem Yahshua will give us that power and make us, you know, fight against our enemies, man. Meaning that they ain't gonna have no chance of defeating us, man. This is on Jeremiah chapter 51, verse 19. The portion of Jacob is not like them. The portion of Jacob, once again, is talking about the elect, man, 144,000 and 1/3. For he is the former of all things, and Israel is the rod of his inheritance. They go that word rod again. Rod meaning, you know, rulership, man. The nation of Israel starts off with the elect, is about to get the next rulership, man. And Israel is the rod of his inheritance. The Lord of hosts is his name. Thou art my battle axe and weapons of war. So the Lord prepared the remnant, the nation of Israel, the elect, as his battle axe and weapons of war, man. He not say we're going to use a battle axe or weapons of war. He said that we are the weapons of war, man. The battle axe and weapons of war represent that we are the ones that he's going to choose the fight, man, with that spiritual power, man. Meaning that we're going to be Superman. Thou art my battle axe, weapons of war. With thee will I break in pieces the nation. With thee will I destroy kingdoms. Talking about the American kingdom, the Russian, the Chinese, you know, the Arabs, you know, all the heathenistic, you know, the heathen kingdoms that's in rulership, man. The Lord going to raise up the elect to bring them down, man, through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shem Yahshua, with the spiritual power. With thee will I break in pieces the horse and his rider. With thee will I break in pieces the chair and his rider. And represent their military, man. The armies that they have, man. These heathens got, man. You know, we're going to be able to destroy them, man, by the power of Yahweh Shem Yahusha, man. With thee also will I break in pieces men and women. With thee will I break in pieces old and young. The Lord ain't discriminating, man. If you old, young, man, and women, Lord gonna give his men that power, man, such a fierce spirit, and he gonna, you know, they gonna be able to destroy, you know, men, women, and children, man, old and young, man. You know, cause right now, man, we in this flesh, man, we can't go out there and, you know, kill a little young child or a woman like that, man. You know, you gonna have to have a fierce anger on you in that time, man. You know, cause yes, the Lord do talk about death, man. When you read these scriptures, man, they talk about death more than salvation of life, man. But that's what the Lord is coming with, man, with death, man. But only salvation or life is coming for a few, the elect of the nation of Israel, man. Because the majority of the world is in wickedness, man. So the Lord is going to talk about, you know, death and destruction most of the time, man, in the scriptures, man. With thee will I break in pieces the horse and his rider. With thee will I break in pieces the chariot and his rider. With thee also will I break in men and women. And with thee will I break in pieces old and young. And with thee will I break in pieces the young man and the maid. I will also break in pieces with thee the shepherd and his flock. Represent these, you know, false pastors, man. You know, these false, you know, these pastors, these religious. Lord gonna set us up, man. The men of the Lord. You know, praying that we part of that, the elect, man, to get that spiritual power. To, you know, to recompense. You know, these people, man, pay them back for what they've done unto the men of the Lord. And what they, and also their wickedness, man, following these false gods, man, these false idols, man. And with thee will I break in pieces the husband and his yoke of oxen. With thee will I break in pieces the captains and rulers. You know, so the Lord going to make, you know, set up his men to destroy the army, the false prophets. You know, these, you know, he going to set up his men to destroy these wicked people out here, man. You know. Because we're going to be part of the Lord, Yahweh, and Yahshua, righteous judgment. You know, the Lord going to use his men, his people, his chosen people, to start out with the elect, to be the one to justify his righteous judgment here on the earth, man. And I will render unto Babylon, to all the inhabitants of Chaldea, all the evil that they had done in Zion in your sight, say Yahweh. So the Lord going to destroy America, man. He's going to set up his men to fight against America, man. American troops, American, you know, people, you know, these devils trying to come at us and, you know, trying to call us terrorists, you know, but they started the war first against us, man. And now all of a sudden you see Negro, Latino, Native Americans, you know, coming up saying how much, you know, saying that the spirit, the power of the Bible, Yahweh Shah is with us, man. He gonna raise us up and give us recompense and pay y'all back for what y'all done. Now we the terrorists, man. Now we the one causing the war, man. All before, man, they started out they by bringing us over here, and what they did to the Latino and Native Americans, that was actions of war, man. You know, we still at war, man. Look how your court system is against us, man. You know, look how the whole system is against the so-called Negro, Latino, and Native American. But now you're trying to call it reverse racism, man. But the Lord is not hearing that, man. The Lord is about, you know, righteous judgment and righteous balance, man. You know, so... No, you now it's time for you to pay for what you've done to the Negro, Latino, and Native Americans, man. The children of Israel, man. The Most High Yahweh Bashem Yahushah, people, man. You know, so you can do all the tactics that you want, trying to get the men of the Lord off the street, shut down the video. But that still ain't gonna change the fact that the Lord is about to bring judgment on you so called white people and the rest of you heathens, man. And I'm gonna get this scripture. We don't fear you devils, man. You know, you don't need to fear you devils, man, because, you know, the Lord is with us, man. So if you, you know, you want to put your hands on the man of the Lord, man, and say that you murder some of the men of the Lord, man, Yahweh Yahshua going to raise us up, man. You know, and we going to get our revenge anyway, man. You know, because death ain't nothing, man. You know, we got a lot of the people in the world that's scared to die, man. Not knowing the meaning of death, man. Death ain't nothing but one transition from, you know, from this life to the next life, which is the spiritual realm, man. And the Lord send you back on the earth, man. You know, to live out your life again, what you call reincarnation, man. This is on Jeremiah 16, verse 16. Behold, I will send for many fishes, say Yahweh, and they shall fish them. And the fishes represent the man that's on the highways and byways, you know, going out there preaching this word, man. Fishing who? They're the elect, man. Those that coming in, that's going to be part of the Lord, Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushah, elect, man. Praying that we part of that number, man. That's why we out there on the highways and byways, man. You know, because that's what we're doing, fishing. The Bible is the bait, man. We baiting the people to come in and be part of Yahweh Shem Yahweh elect, man. You know, if it be the Lord's will, man. And praying that we part of the Lord's, you know, elect, man. You know, but, you know, the scripture says we're going to be good fish and going to be bad fish. But the good fish, the Lord's going to take in. The bad fish, the ones that don't want to hear this word and reject the word, the Lord is going to, you know, throw them back out there, man. Leave them out there to die, man. And so right now we in fishing season, man, putting the videos, the shows, you know, on doing the ministry of Yahweh Shem Yahweh. Verse 16, and after what I send for many hunters, so the Lord is going to turn this man into hunters, man. You know, after he sealed the elect, man, he's going to turn them to hunters, and they're going to have that spiritual power, man. And they shall hunt them from every mountain and from every hill. Some of these big governments and these small governments, man. And out of the holes of the rocks, talking about you churches, you know, you people that are going to be running and trying to escape, man. Lord going to have nothing but judgment coming for you people, man. There's an old saying that you can't run, but you can't hide, man. You can't hide from Yahweh Shem Yahweh, man. The Lord, to his eyes, are 10,000 times brighter than the sun, man. So none of you people can hide or run from the judgment of Yahweh Shem Yahweh. The only way you can run and hide from the judgment of Yahweh Shem Yahweh, if you part of the elect and you're doing the will and having the faith in Yahweh Shem Yahweh, and he have mercy upon you, and you come back into these scriptures, man, read them and proclaim the word, praying that the Lord deliver you, man. That the only way you can be hide and be escape the judgment of Yahweh Shem Yahweh, man. If you're not with the truth, man, the Lord is going to destroy you, man. Clean and simple, man. The only life is life or death, man. His way or that, his way of life or his way of death, man. The Lord even going to deliver you if you believe it and having faith and doing the right thing, or the Lord going to destroy you if you don't believe and you're doing wickedness, man. That's how it goes, man. That what time we living in, man. The Lord coming back to bring great judgment, man. This is on Isaiah chapter 59, verse 19. So shall they fear the name of Yahweh by Shem Yahweh from the west. And the west is represent the western hemisphere over here in America, man. When the enemy, and his glory from the rising of the sun, we represent this knowledge, man. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the spirit of Yahweh shall lift up a standard against him. And who's the enemy, man? You so-called white people, man. You your military, man. Your martial law troops. Your FEMA camp or your FEMA troops, man. You know, your NATO troops, man. You know, when they come in as a flood, as an army, man, to come against the men of the Lord, you know, because they're going to come in and catch two-thirds of our people. You know, and these rest of these heathen. But when they come up against the men of the Lord, the ones that the elect, that Yahweh Shem Yahweh has sealed with their power, man, Lord gonna lift up that standard, man. And that word standard meaning the put the flight or the flight. You know, basically, man, we're gonna be putting your armies to flight, man. Cause the Lord say, you know, our enemies shall come in one way, but flee seven different ways, man. You know, I mean, when y'all come in that army formation, man, when the Lord raise up his men with that spiritual power, man, y'all gonna be scattering, man, from the fear of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shah, that he gonna give the power to his men, that y'all gonna be running, man. You know, cause ain't nothing gonna be able to stop us, man. This is on Isaiah chapter 54, verse 17. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper. So any weapon, like I said, that y'all devils come up with, man, ain't going to prosper, man. It's going to fail, man. When the Lord raises up his men with that spiritual power, man. And every tongue that shall raise up, that raise against thee in judgment, thou shalt condemn. And that going to you scoffers and you non-believers, man. Because we're not coming with our own mind, man. We're coming out of the scriptures of Yahweh, Bashim, Yahweh, Shah, man, the right way. How the Lord attained it to be, man. You know, so when y'all come up against these scriptures, man, or come against the men of the Lord, y'all basically come against Yahweh, Bashim, Yahweh, Shah. That way y'all can't condemn us, man, but y'all condemn yourself, man. This is the heritage of the servants of Yahweh. Who the servants of the Yahweh, man? The prophets, man. The man that's on the highways and byways, pushing the truth and in the faith and in the ministry, man. Uplifting the name of Yahweh, Shem, Yahshua, and proclaiming his words, man. Those are servants. And the righteousness is of me. Because the Lord said the righteousness is of me. Meaning, because he woke them up and he put the spirit on them to go out there and preach this word, man. You know, ready the people here forbid, man. So you can't condemn us, man. Because you coming against us is basically you going against Yahweh, Shem, Yahshua, the creator, man. The true creator. And since you want to do that, man, you people that scoff and scorn, you non-believers, the Lord is going to destroy y'all, man. Say Yahweh. I'm going to get this last scripture, you know, I'm going to close it out. This is Isaiah chapter 40, verse 27. Why sayest thou, O Jacob, and speakest, O Israel, my way is hid from the Lord, and my judgment is passed over from my power? And then we have today, man. You Negro, Latino, Native Americans that don't believe in Yahweh, Bashim, Yahweh, Shah, man. I think the Lord forgot about us, man. You know, asking the question, if the Lord, you know, is real, and if he love us, man, why he, you know, got us in this position that we in? Not knowing, you know, because that's selfish, man, because not knowing that if y'all had any, you know, spiritual mind and understanding that the nation of Israel went against Yahweh, Bashim, Yahweh, Shah, man. So that's why the Lord sent us over here in captivity on our enemies, man, to pay for our sins, man. But if you come back in the time that the Lord got his hands stretched out, you know, praying to the Lord and believing on him, man, he's going to save us, man. Save us, because we're the only people that the Lord, Yahweh, Bashim, Yahweh, Shah, care about, man. The rest of the heathen nation, the Lord look at them as his enemy, man. For he chose the nation of Israel to be his only people, man. But our people don't want that, man. They want to continue on forgetting about the Lord, not trusting in Yahweh, Bashim, Yahweh, Shah, and following the ways of this world and following the ways of you so-called white people, man. And, but the Lord is coming back to deliver those that believe on him, man, the elect, man. My way is hid from Yahweh, and my judgment is passed over from my power. Verse 28. Hast thou not known, hast thou not heard, that the everlasting power, the Lord Yahweh, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary, there is no searching of his understanding. So the scripture saying, asking the question, has I not heard or known? It's basically, you know, the scripture being sarcastic, you know, being funny, because, you know, these people out here, they know about Yahweh, Bashim, Yahweh, Shah, man, through his spirit that he put on his prophets, man. You know, because the Lord, the scripture say, verily, verily, the sound has went out throughout the whole earth, man, through the way of the internet, brothers on the highways and byways. So these people know or heard about the power of Yahweh, Bashim, Yahweh, Shah, and what his true intention of in the scriptures, what he got prepared and what he got, you know, set for what about to come, man. You know, but they don't want to take heed, man. But those that take heed, man, that's what Lord gonna bless them with, man. Verse 29, he giveth power to the faint, and we are fainted, man. We weak, man. You know, you got these weak bodies. You know, we, our people, the most people that, you know, being sick, you know, being on drugs, you know, and we, you know, we the Lord chosen people, man. Like I said, the Lord did that to punish us for us going off against his law, statute, commandment. So that's why we need the Lord, man, because we supposed to be the top nation that on high over these other nations, man. And to them that have no might, he increased strength. And we don't have no might, man. We under our enemies, man. We don't have our own kingdom, man. You know, so the Lord gonna have to, you know, raise us up, man. He said he gonna increase our strength, man. Meaning that he gonna increase our strength physically, mentally, and spiritually, man. I'll
continue with that spiritual power, man. We're gonna be at that super script, you know, doing amazing things, man. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young man shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon Yahweh shall renew their strength and shall mount up with wings as eagles, and they shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. So basically, the Lord will ultimately give us that optimal status, man. Be able to run at top speed and don't get tired. Be able to walk and don't get tired. And be able to fly, man. The Lord said we're going to mount up as wings, with wings as an eagle, man. Meaning, be able to jump high, to fly, man. And, you know, so, you know, the Lord got great things, you know, in store for the nation of Israel, man. The elect, those that believe on them, man. You know, brothers in the truth that got this understanding, man. We looking for the power of Yahweh, man, to deliver us, man. And the power of the Lord to give us so we can, you know, destroy our enemies, man. And do all type of, miracles, you know, majesty works, man. And that's what we're looking for, man. Because Yahweh and Yahshua is the true power, man. And we got faith that he exists, man. And sooner or later, man, these people are going to see that the Lord exists when he start bringing all these prophecies, you know, the past, man. When he start bringing judgment on America. Or when he raise up the nation of Israel, is elect with that spiritual power. And they really gonna believe when the Lord Yahweh Shah come back with the chariots, man, and the host of angels to deliver the elect and to bring destruction upon those that don't believe, man. You know, so, you know, I pray that, you know, this brother's been edifying, that this video, you know, been edifying. So next time I'm gonna give all praise to Yahweh Shah. You know, double honor to the apostles and the elders and great millstone. You know, brothers out there, just keep fighting, keep pushing, man. Have that faith. The Lord gonna give us that spiritual power, man. Because the Lord is gonna raise the nation of Israel up, man, according to the scriptures, man. And brothers in the faith, man, we pray that we're part of that number, man, the elect, man. You know, so like it. So brothers out there, keep pushing, keep fighting, man, keep praying, man. But we are almost at the end of America and the end of Esau's kingdom, man. Edom kingdom. And uplifting and rise of Yahshua Allah, man. So Quam Yahshua Allah, you know, and Kala Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, Bahashim, Kal Kodash, man. Shalom, Bahaf Dawadah.